Hello students, welcome to today's lecture of Theory of Machines. Today we will discuss the analysis of brakes, especially about the block brakes. This will be the part 1 of the lecture and it will be continued tomorrow as well. Having studied about the basics of the brakes in the previous lectures, including the classification and construction and working of different types of brakes, we should now start the analysis of brakes. So today we will start the analysis of block brakes. And we'll derive some equations which will be used to solve the problems based on block brakes. What are block brakes? You've already seen this. We'll just capitulate on it. A single block brake or shoe brake consists of a block or a shoe which is pressed against a rotating drum. The block is rigidly fixed to the lever and the force is applied at one end of the lever and the other end is pivoted to a fixed fulcrum. As the force is applied to the lever, the block is pressed against the rotating drum and the brake is applied. So let's see how this is working. So this is a typical single shoe or single block brake. This is the lever. This is the fulcrum point to which this end of the lever is pivoted. This is the drum which will be rotating. And at this end of the, at the free end of the lever, we will be applying the force so that the drum could be stopped. So let's see how this is taking place. So this is how the brake is applied. Let's see once again. Now this brake shoe is applying some pressure or some force on this drum. Actually speaking, this pressure that has been applied on the drum is not uniform. It is something like this. So it is varying. It will be maximum because the force will be applied somewhere here. So it will be maximum at the center and it will go on reducing on both the sides. And this will be symmetric on both the sides. So this is actually based on the angle 2 theta. So suppose this block is constituting an angle 2 theta at the center of the drum. 2 theta is taken such that this side is theta and this side is also theta. So this becomes 2 theta. This is known as a contact angle. So if this 2 theta is less than 60 degree, then the pressure is assumed to be uniform. But here, as it is greater than 60 degree, so this pressure will not be uniform. So the variation of pressure or variation of the force will have a varied friction coefficient. So the concept is such that the equivalent force or the concentrated force that will be acting on this drum should apply the same frictional torque. So for that, the equivalent friction coefficient is given by mu dash is equal to mu 4 sine theta divided by 2 theta plus sine 2 theta. So this 60 degree actually comes from this. So if we put the values of theta and draw a curve, then it is found that up till theta is equal to 30 degree, this pressure is nearly same. So above 30 degree or the value of 2 theta above 60 degree, the pressure will be varying. So let's move further. Suppose we see an example of a brake shoe which is substanding and which is having a contact angle less than 60 degree. Suppose this is the case. This, you can see, it is nearly uniform pressure that has been acting on the drum. As the angle substanded by this shoe, that is 2 theta, is less than 60 degree. So the pressure which will be applied on the drum will be nearly uniform. So we can replace this pressure or this distributed pressure by a single force as like this. And this force will be always assumed to be acting at the center of the block. And it will be passing, the line of action of this force will be passing through the center of the drum as well. Moving ahead, let us see what are the forces that will be acting on the drum and the block and we will also see the free body diagram. So this is the case. Now after this force P is applied here, this will be stopping the drum like this. Now having pressed the drum, the block will be applying certain radial force on the drum, and in reaction to that, the drum will be applying some normal reaction to the block, which is something like this. So this will be the normal reaction of the drum on the block in response to the radial force that will be applied by the block on the drum. So this red one is the radial force that will be applied by the block, and this is the normal reaction, that is reaction of the drum to the block. Knowing this force, let us simultaneously draw the free body diagram also, so that we can visualize the forces. So let's draw. So suppose this is the drum which is rotating in the clockwise direction, and this is the lever which is pivoted here, and this is the force P applied. So as discussed, these force can be plotted here like this. This is the reaction of drum on the block, and this is the radial force applied by the block on the drum. Now as this drum is rotating in the clockwise direction, we know that the friction force always acts in the direction opposite to the motion. So if we try to plot the velocity at this point on the drum, then the velocity will be in the tangential direction towards right side. That means the motion is towards this direction, right side. So the force of friction will be acting in the opposite direction, that is towards the left side, if the drum is rotating in the clockwise direction as shown here. So this will be the force of friction on the drum in the direction opposite to the direction of the motion. So this can be plotted here like this. You can see this. This is the force of friction on the drum that will be in the opposite direction to the movement of the drum. Similarly, according to the Newton's third law, equal and opposite reaction will be there on this friction force on the block. So the block will be experiencing the friction force towards the right direction, in the direction opposite to the this friction force. So it will be something like this. So this will be the friction force which will be acting on the block towards right. So this can be plotted here like this. So this will be the force of friction on the block, which will be in the direction opposite to the force of friction on the drum. So as we know, according to the Coulomb's friction, this force of friction will be nothing but equal to mu times n. This force of friction will be equal to mu times the normal force. Now this fulcrum point will not always pass through the point of contact of the drum and the block as shown here. This is at this position, it is passing through the point of contact of the drum and the block, but it may be placed differently. This lever can be pivoted at various different positions. Suppose it is pivoted here, and this will be at a distance of b from this line passing through the point of contact. Similarly, it can be at this position also. So in this position, it will be below the line passing through the point of contact, and the distance may be b, suppose. So these can be the various positions of the fulcrum point. So let us see them one by one, how the force analysis can be done. So this is all for today's lecture. We'll continue this lecture and discuss the another configuration of this single block break. I hope you have understood up till now. In case of any doubt, please feel free to contact me. Thank you.